Well, some argue that responsible business is the key to success, but a big question, can it really be profitable? Jeff Hollander joins us now to discuss. He's a co-founder and chairman of Seventh Generation. He's also the self-titled chief inspired protagonist. I wish we could all name ourselves. I think that's a great one. You've talked about, Jeff, a new era of responsibility in business. Can you do it and make money?
We've been doing it and making money. Seventh Generation has grown at an average rate of 30% a year for 10 years now. The company's been profitable. And I believe increasingly the companies that are the most successful will be the most responsible, sustainable companies.
And you've said you really, whatever business you're in, from big banks to what Seventh Generation does to green cleaning supplies, if you will, and other items, you have to dare to be see-through.
Well, in today's world, I mean, look, you look at the business you're in. I mean, so much information comes through to people in ways that it didn't used to before. Mm-hmm. So we live in an environment where companies used to think they controlled the messaging by issuing a press release.
No, but they don't. The day and age of Twitter and social media.
So in a world in which the public generates the information, employees, customers, companies don't control that message. To frame that message, they need to be transparent. They need to be see-through. And business needs to talk about the good, the bad, the ugly. And it's a hard thing for business to do.
Right.
They're afraid to tell people the things they screwed up, the things they did wrong. But the truth is, we've been doing it for 22 years. And we have built an incredibly authentic brand with very loyal customers by being honest in a way that makes my lawyer almost want to fall off his chair.
I can imagine. You talk about a lot of that in your book here. We have it, The Responsibility Revolution. You brought to mind also a company very different than yours, but Domino's and the advertisements that Domino's has had recently saying, listen, we knew our pizza wasn't up to your standards before. Here's what we've changed. It was very eye-opening to see that. You're seeing that more and more now, aren't you?
I mean, consumers are so cynical about business. All you do is hear about the terrible things business is doing. Business can only build loyalty and trust by being honest, mm-hmm. no matter how much it hurts.
When you look at successes and failures in terms of your philanthropic endeavors, have you had both? If so, what's been most successful and where have you been disappointed? Yeah.
You got to have failures. If you're not failing, you're not trying hard enough. Boy, we started something called Learning to Make a Difference, and we were going to help revolutionize the school fundraising business. There was going to be no more pizza, there was going to be no more candy and no more wrapping paper, only good environmental healthy products.
Good luck.
Failed.
Yeah, well, aggressive.
We were ahead of our time.
Okay.
But I think the whole Planet Foundation, which works with the Grameen Bank, they're doing micro-enterprise lending in Queens successfully. 99%+ of the women pay the money back. They're starting businesses. And people said, oh, yeah, you can do that in Bangladesh, but it's never going to work in New York. And it's working wonderfully in New York City. And we're proud to be providing money to women to help start businesses that no one else is willing to do.
Yeah, it's also passing on not only the entrepreneurial gene, I guess, but also the way of doing business that you believe in most.
Yeah, and I mean, that's sort of the lesson in the responsibility revolution is there is a new way to do business. The way that we've been doing business isn't working. Mm-mm. It needs to change. Who are the best models of that revolution? What is the business case that outlines the success of that revolution? And my God, if we don't make this change, the world is not going to be the kind of place I'm going to want my children to live in.